Welcome to the history, welcome to the culture, welcome to community that dreams and achieves, living in change for better tomorrow. Welcome to the Eunice Mala Show.
Welcome to the Eunice Mala Show. I'm your host, Eunice Malath. We're going to go ahead and continue with this series on the community movie called If I Only Knew. I hope that last week you watched the program and this week it'll sort of be building up upon it. Now we're going to go ahead and watch, of course, the story of Fonny Ngondu, a young teenager who falls in love with a boy named Deng. And throughout the whole process, we watch her life unravel. So here's the movie.
Which friend of yours?
I have a lot of friends.
A lot of friends? You don't go to Sudanese friends, you just go to American friends? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
What's the difference? They're all friends.
We have been trying to bring you up as a Sudanese girl. You know this very well. And you know very well that in this house, there is no visiting friends, visiting neighbors, going to parties.
Okay, so what am I supposed to do exactly in the house? Besides,
you have to
wash
follow
dishes,
our culture.
Do homework, and
yes, that's what you're supposed to be doing.
Really?
Like your mother did. That's how your mother
okay,
was brought up.
Do you even hear yourself right now? I'm tired of this so-called culture thing. Okay? We're not in Africa. We're in America. Okay? Do you want me to spell it out for you?
Talk to
America?
Me like that? You dare talk to me like that?
Okay, I'm not trying to be disrespectful, Dad, but really,
though,
I need some freedom. Okay?
Which freedom are you talking about?
Let me go out with my friends without you like being all.
You go out with your friends and then you come past midnight. And what do you mean?
Okay, well, if you guys wouldn't keep me so controlled in the house, I wouldn't have to lie to you and I wouldn't have to come home at this time. And you wouldn't be so worried.
Look at the dress you're wearing.
What's wrong with the dress I'm wearing? It's too short for your culture?
It is.
Oh, really?
Have you come from a boy's home?
Dad.
Have you? Tell me the truth. Have you?
It's not really your business.
Fonny, you've become an American girl.
That's what I look like? I guess so.
We try to bring you up in our culture. And that's what you tell me? And you disrespect me?
I'm not disrespecting you. I'm not even trying to disrespect you. But it's kind of hard sometimes.
Freedom. If you are not going to be listening to the rules of this house, obeying the rules of this house, following the rules of this house, you'll get out of this house. Do you know that? And if it was in Africa, I would have slapped you. Here, you call 911. Every time, 911.
Because here, they call it child abuse. And
child
it's against
abuse.
The law.
Child abuse. When I try to correct you, you say it's child abuse? That's how we were brought up. 911. If you're not going to follow the rules in this house, Fonny, you're out of this house.
Oh my God, please get out of my face, Dad.
You dare tell me that? Fonny, you dare tell me that? You dare tell me that?
Dad! You
get
know what
here.
I am?
Get out of here!
I'm gonna call the police!
Look at you. 911. Call the police.
Yes, 911.
You think I care?
Call the police.
You think I care? Go call the police.
Now you're gonna go to jail.
Go to jail. Look at her. That's not how we brought children up. Nobody listens to us anymore. What's all this about? The child comes to you at this time of the night. That's not the way we were brought up. This is just too much. God. Respect.
He's such an African. You're going to jail now.
Look at her.
Stupid African parent. Can't believe you hit me. Hello? Is this the police? Is this the police? Lady, are you deaf? I said, is this the police? Okay, well, I just came home from a party and my dad hit me. And that's child abuse, so he needs to be arrested or something. Yeah? You're putting me on hold? This is an emergency! You can't put me on hold! What's wrong with you? No, okay. Okay, I was with some friends and he has accused me of beating up with boys and stuff and he hit me. He was beating up on me. Come arrest him. You want the address? Okay. Well, you know, forget it. Ah! Goodness. Ah! Gosh, I hate him. Stupid African parents always, oh, you can't do this, you can't do that.
Yeah. want to get in trouble because they do, and mind they can't see my friend, we're both going to be busted.
Can I have some sympathy? See, now no, I can't dude, talk.
You see, if my parents come here, we're both going to be in trouble. And they probably want to think I'm pregnant.
Okay!
If you can't do
man,
it.
Man, why you always, why do you always got to get loud?
I'm getting loud because this thing is so you're serious.
So you're so
ghetto. You think I want to be caught on a pregnancy test in my house?
Stop being ghetto. Gosh. Oh, okay. I need your support, okay? I need your help. And you yelling at me is not helping. I need you to be the
this
strong one.
This is scary
one.
For me too, dude. This is too scary for me. Leave your car down at school in the bathroom somewhere and leave it there. Not in my parents' house.
Do you think I want this to happen?
If you cannot do it in your parents' house, what do you think you could do it here?
What you,
you
trying
think
to
my
say?
Parents would have tripped
what
up, like,
you trying
your
to say?
Because I think you're trying to get me in trouble. That's what
I'm are you serious, Mary? I'm not trying to get you in trouble.
You're trying to get me in trouble.
How am I trying to get you in trouble?
Anyway, did you hear anything?
Okay, you're supposed to be my friend. You're supposed to be my friend.
Oh my God, sometimes you just, oh!
You get on my nerves. I don't even know why I'm friends with you.
Oh my God. Hurry up, do the damn thing.
Shut up. I'm not doing that. You gotta find out for me. Here. Oh, gosh. I can't stand you sometimes. Oh.
Damn thing says.
Oh, hurry up.
Don't rush me, little girl. I'm just doing you a favor. That's what
you
it is.
You need to calm down.
You lucky I love you. I would not be doing
this. Ah, shut up.
Sure. You sure act like you're pregnant.
That is not funny.
Well, you should have kept your legs closed in the first place.
I learned it from you.
Just because I lost my virginity before you, huh? Did I end up getting pregnant? Can you move your damn face out of my face?
Who was in that room?
Can you move your damn face
out of my
face?
Who was in the room with that one dude talking about you?
Can you just move the damn piss, please?
You need to calm down before I pour that piss on your face.
Oh my God, you know what? I'm about to in a minute if you don't stop getting smart me. For real. I'm so
God will care.
Man, shut up.
Alright. So annoying.
Alright, here it says.
Next time I'm making some good friends. Quiet friends.
Alright, it says we have to dip this steak or something. Let's open it up and see what's in there. Can't believe I'm
anytime
going through all
now.
Of this.
I can't look. Oh my gosh. Tell me what it says.
It's not coming yet.
What does it say?
It's not coming yet. Damn, be patient.
Stop yelling at me!
I cannot win. Home for real. Alright, it says we have to wait 1 minute anyway.
1 minute?
Yeah.
That's gonna be like the longest 1 minute of my life. Oh.
This. One line is negative and two line is positive. So let's wait and see what it says.
Oh my gosh. Okay, what does it say, Mary? Come on now.
Oh my God.
You're playing with me, right?
It's two. No, bro, I'm not kidding. It's two unless it's wrong, unless I read it wrong. It says it right here. Look, it's right here. Two lines is positive. Maybe it's wrong or something. Maybe it's wrong. You know, they're not always accurate. Phone, just wait until you go to the doctor, okay? Because it's not always right. They're always wrong. I know my friend did it last time and it was negative, even though it says it was positive. Don't worry. Okay, just go to the doctor. Just go to the doctor, dude. You don't know if it's right. It could be wrong, too. Just hurry up. We gotta go.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
I thought you had a good time today.
I did.
Talk about I'm seeing a smile on that pretty face.
I didn't know how to tell you this, but, I am pregnant.
What? What do you mean you're pregnant?
I'm pregnant.
By who? Whose baby is it?
Are you serious? Ask me that question again.
I'm saying, by who? Who got you pregnant? Whose baby
is it? By you,
is
your baby.
How can I be sure about that?
Are you serious? Who have I been sleeping with?
I don't know. I don't know who you've been sleeping with.
Okay, so now you want to argue about this. Remember when I told you to use a condom in the first place?
You should have been on the pills in the first place.
Oh my God, you are so ridiculous. I can't believe you are one of those. So you gonna knock me up and then act stupid? For real?
I don't even know what I'm arguing about. Because this is not my baby. I'm not sure this is my baby. I don't know who you've been sleeping with.
Okay, let me tell you this. It's your baby whether you like it or not.
No,
okay?
It is not.
Oh,
no,
it's not
my baby.
It's not?
No, it's not.
Okay. So you know what? This is why we have a lot of baby mamas up in here. All you have Sudanese men just... The only thing you guys know how to do is knock people up and then walk away.
Oh. Sudanese man now?
Yes, Sudanese man. Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Is that the reason you guys go sleeping around and accuse Sudanese man for not taking care of babies?
That is what you guys think. Not everybody's like that. Okay? But obviously, you guys are. All y'all want to do is just knock people up and run away from your problems. If you were a real man, you would be here and take care of this child.
Responsibility.
But now you're acting all stupid.
What responsibilities do I have?
This responsibility.
You don't even know. You don't even know who the father of the baby is,
oh
and you're asking me for responsibilities?
So
what responsibilities?
So you're calling me a bitch. That's what you're saying. You're saying I'm going around sleeping around with people, right? You're calling me a bitch, right? Please call me a bitch. Call me a bitch. Say it.
Whatever you do, all I know is that baby is not mine. You don't even know who the father is. But whatever you do, it's your choice. It's up to you.
This baby is yours whether you like it or not. I
hope you're not one of those Sudanese girls who try to pin the brother down with a baby.
Pin you down? I can get any man I want. Do I have to pin you down? If you want to walk, go ahead and walk. And see if I come running after you. Hell no, I would not. Okay? I am not trying to pin you down. What for?
You better not wish that you're trying to get any money from me.
What money? You ain't got no money.
I got money. I'm going to medical school. I'm going to medical school.
There's the difference. You're going to school. You're going to school. You don't have money yet. You can say that. Okay? You don't have money. You're broke. Please. Don't play with me. Don't fool me. Okay? You don't have any money.
I have money. That's why I'm going to medical school.
First of all, I am not a gold digger.
That's why I'm going to medical school.
I am not a gold digger.
I didn't say that, but...
I am not a gold digger.
I didn't say that, but, you know, you girls have some kind of twisted mentality of trying to pin a brother down and mess up their future with...
Oh, my God. So you think...
You don't even know where they come from.
You and your big bald head. Really? You are not all that. You are not all that, okay?
Oh, I'm not all that?
Yes, you're not all
that. Is that right?
Yes, that is so right.
Okay.
Yes.
You should have not opened your leg in the first place then.
You opened it. Now you got a responsibility. So either
I
be
don't
here.
Have a responsibility.
Either stay
I don't,
and be a man or
I
run run away like a little girl.
I don't
be
have
a man or run like a little girl.
I don't have a responsibility.
See, Matt, this is
I don't
why
know whose baby
this
that is
why I don't never want to mess with no Sudanese guy in the first place.
You know what? Screw you.
Get to stepping.
Screw you. As a matter of fact, find someone to
Oh,
take
don't worry about
tonight.
It. I got my rights lined
okay.
up. Screw
Forget
you.
Then.
Get to stepping. Take yourself to hell.
Oh! Aya Agnes Agbata Kishunu, ER Cave, Radio Taki Cave. It is a Agbata Peter Fijahila, Peter Radio Tasara. Wallahi ana so maga pita leta hamilo marata zoltani kirina ina sara biga bikerim shirukas mato kere babru rkef de jerima de wallahi ai makalam vega hasi gaba shahrin tamasuma ya wallahi mashakil toma mapita fi bet Gala do turuju marato, vega sara za tu turuju pita mi bed. Ya. Tarande hasil. Eta magigen fi beni ta maga suma, fi shiri kira fi hila. Ai? Wallahi kere fi iristan geri bade tal kere asma ita nas bi wonu sinak.
Ai de irista bini ya morokira. Ma zuma na lakin ana birwa. Ai? Wallahi je. Fi bini ya tani hina jani kira na inu kere uwa zushinu. Uwa givi ya de. Ai? Kira na inu uwa zushinu. What can I do for you?
I'm here to see the pastor.
Why are you here to see the pastor?
It's about something personal.
There's a rumor going around that you're praying. Is that what you want to talk to the pastor about?
You know what? I actually remember I have to go do something important, so I gotta go.
You can wait and have a seat. The pastor is seeing someone, and when he's done, you'll be next. He can see you.
No, thanks.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Good luck with your pregnancy.
Call me for the baby shower, okay? Aya Agnes, Malaysia na sivita hold. Guess munu jaini. Defo ni binieta mama Regina. Binia de hami. Ilta seyas magbara, fihila.
Let's count the world's ocean.
Alright.
The Atlantic Ocean comes, and goes and stuff like that.
Okay. Are you trying to tickle me?
No, I'm not tickling you.
You're
come on
to
now.
Tickle
relax. Okay. I said I'm not tickling you. Right. Come on now. Look at me.
I trust you.
Say, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. And then how many ocean we got left?
I don't know.
Four more.
Okay.
So the Pacific comes, and it stops right there. Come on now. I'm not tickling you.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
I can't handle it.
No, I would not. Okay,
I'm so
I would
ticklish.
Not. Look at me. Okay, I'm not.
Okay, all right.
Then the Indian Ocean comes,
uh-huh.
and goes, and goes.
Baby?
Yes.
You know we've been together for 2 years now.
I know it's been 2 years already. Wow, time has gone by fast.
I know. Do you remember when our anniversary is?
Of course I do.
Okay, what is it?
February 2nd.
Are you sure?
Yes, I am sure.
I think it's February 4th.
You think so?
Well, actually, you're right. You're right, it's February 2nd. You know what? I just got a call yesterday from one of my cousins in Texas. And she told me that she's getting married.
Really? Who? Who's getting married?
Yanding.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Well, that's nice. Okay. Then we gotta be going for a wedding then.
I know, but okay. You know what? I was thinking about our own. It's not funny. It is not funny.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's funny?
No, it's...
You don't want to marry me?
Of course I will marry you anyway.
Then what's funny about it?
No, it's not that it's funny. It's just that, you know, in the context of your cousin wedding, and then you said, you know, now thinking about us.
But think about it, though. You know,
yeah.
We've been together for 2 years, and she's only been with her boyfriend, her fiancé now, for a year.
Next week, we'll be continuing on the community movie called If I Only Knew. We hope you'll join us then here on the Eunice Malat Show. Thank you.
If you believe, you can achieve.